value of Sibos to me has evolved over the years. I have participated in the Innotribe Startup Challenge. I've come back as a growth stage innovator alumni. And in most recent years, I've been very happy to support and host the Future of Money session at Sibos. I'm delighted to be back, albeit virtually, at this year's Sibos, where I will again be hosting the SWIFT Innotribe flagship session, The Future of Money. Last year, I opened the session with a slide that read, "The history of money is the history of humanity." I quoted Yuval Noah Harari in detailing that the development of money, quote, required no technological breakthroughs. It was a purely mental revolution. As Professor Harari has said, it involved the creation of a new intersubjective reality that exists solely in people's shared imagination. So the question this time around is, how might this intersubjective reality shift in the coming years? Whether as a consequence of, yes, technological breakthroughs, geopolitical upheavals, global pandemics, or other forces as yet unseen. What are likely to be the social, political, economic, and cultural implications of this shift? From Bitcoin to Libra, from the exorbitant privilege enjoyed by the US dollar to China's central bank issued digital currency, from cold hard cash to cold storage crypto, who gets to decide on what the future of money will look like and who gets to push back? Join us at Sibos to find out.